हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम वंस अगेन टू माय केमिस्ट्री चैनल अमेजिंग केमिस्ट्री क्लासेस। सो दिस इज माय थर्ड वीडियो ऑफ डीएनएफ ब्लॉक एलिमेंट। एज यू गाइस कैन सी, दिस इज एन एनसीईआरटी बुक वेयर यू कैन सी द टेट्राहेड्रल मैग्नेट स्ट्रक्चर ग्रीन इन कलर एंड टेट्राहेड्रल पर मैग्नेट दैट इज पर्पल आयन इन कलर। एज यू कैन सी इट, वेरियस न्यू रिएक्शंस आर गिवन ओवर हेयर। सो ऑल आई कैन से इज दैट एज फार एज इनऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री इज कंसर्न, the reactions which you need to learn, you have to practice a lot of time. Otherwise, what happen at the time of paper, you get confused. And at times, people, students, those who are actually very good in chemistry, but during examination, they get confused and at times, they are not able to write down the reactions. So my advice is that keep your NCERT with you and whenever you sit for the chemistry subject, you have to write down. So keep a notebook with you, make a proper notes, and I am uploading number of videos on different topics, that is your P block element, D block element. So write down all the questions which I am discussing with you. So let's start with the today video. I am going to discuss about the actinoids few questions and few questions about the transition metals also. Now first one is that why actinoids show irregularities in their electronic configuration. So the answer would be that actinoids involve gradual filling of 5F subshells in their atoms. Actinium has outer electronic configuration, that is 6d1 and 7s2. From thorium, the atomic number is 90 onwards, 5f subshells get progressively filled. So because of almost equal energies of 5f and 6d subshells, there are some doubts regarding the filling of 5f and 6d subshells. So this is the answer because of which what happened, actinoids generally show the irregularities in the electronic configuration. Moving on to the next one, that is why iron has higher enthalpy of atomization. So the answer for this question is that the iron is having a higher enthalpy of atomization than copper because the enthalpy of atomization depend on the number of metallic bonds, which in turn depend on number of unpaired electrons. If I talk about the electronic configuration of iron, here you can see argon and then 3d6 and 4s2. So it has 4 unpaired electrons while copper is having 3d10 and 4s1. So it has only one unpaired electron. So iron forms a stronger metallic bond and thus it is having a higher enthalpy of atomization. Alright, moving on to the next question, that scandium 3 plus ion, that is your cation, is colorless in aqueous solution whereas titanium 3 plus ion is colored. Why is it so? It is because scandium 3 plus ion is colorless in aqueous solution whereas titanium is colored because the color of transition metal is due to DD transitions. As I've already discussed in beginning in my previous videos also, that whenever any transition metal it show color complexes, it is because of the DD transition, unpaired electron in the D block elements, because of which most of the transition elements show the colored complexes. Here the same answer, scandium 3 plus is, the configuration is D0, 3D0. So it is having a noble configuration. If we talk about scandium, that is cation, that is a stable gas configuration. Thus, it has no DD transition and hence no color. However, if I talk about titanium 3 plus has one unpaired electron. So it shows DD transition and hence it is colored in. It shows the color complexes. Moving on to the next one, that why do actinoids show a wide range of oxidation states? Write on similarity between the chemistry of lanthanoid and actinoids. Very important question. So you guys need to write down the points which I have mentioned over here, that the actinoid elements show wide range of oxidation state due to comparable energies. The energies of these subshells, that is 5F, 6D and 7S level, they are having the comparable energies. Secondly, the electronic configuration. If we talk about the electronic configuration of actinoid series, in both the lanthanoids and actinoids, F orbitals are progressively filled. So in the lanthanoids, 4F orbitals are progressively filled, whereas in actinoids, 5F orbitals are progressively filled. Okay. Moving on to the next one, that is the oxidation state. Common oxidation state of lanthanoid and actinoid is plus 3. Some lanthanoids show plus 2 and plus 4 oxidation also. However, if we talk about actinoids, it show only plus 3 and plus 4 are most common. So in lanthanoid, mostly they show plus 3 and in some cases it show plus 2 and plus 4 also. And as far as actinoids are concerned, it shows plus 3 and plus 4 most commonly. Moreover, lanthanoid and actinoid show the atomic and ionic size contraction. Okay. Next point is chemical reactivity. Both are highly reactive and exhibit similar chemical properties. Okay. Now let's discuss about the actinoid contraction. It is greater than the lanthanide contraction. Why it is so? Actinoid contraction is greater than the lanthanide contraction due to poor shielding effect of 5f electronic subshell. Okay, so due to 5f electrons, it shows poor shielding effect. Further, 5f orbitals are extended in space beyond 6s and 6p orbitals, whereas 4f orbitals are buried deep. So this is the answer that why actinoid contraction is greater than the lanthanoid contraction. Coming on to the next one, last question of this video, that why transition metals are formed colored compounds. Already discussed multiple time in my various videos that the colored complexes are due to DD transition. So same answer I have written over here also, that the transition metals have incompletely filled d orbitals and thus unpaired electrons have undergo DD transition by absorbing radiation from the visible region, as a result of which absorption of light in visible region and they radiate complementary colors. So you guys can take a snapshot of this questions and do write down all the answer and practices all the question multiple times so that you will gain confidence. Thank you so much for watching this video. It's my request that do share, like and subscribe my channel.